In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry free worksheet, Permutations versus Combinations. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Now remember, for permutations, order matters. And for combinations, order does not matter. So numbers 1 through 4, it says to state if each scenario involves a permutation or a combination. In number 1, a team of 8 basketball players needs to choose a captain and a co-captain. Would the order of that matter? So I'm going to label the basketball players by numbers. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. If we were to choose numbers 1 and 2, say 1 as captain and 2 as co-captain, the order matters. So if I choose 1 and 2, where 1 is captain and 2 is co-captain, I could also potentially choose 2 and 1, where 2 is captain now and 1 would be co-captain. So in choosing both of those, order would need to matter since the positions are different, captain and co-captain. So in number 1, we have a permutation. In number 2, Rob and Mary are planning trips to 9 countries this year. There are 13 countries they would like to visit. They are deciding which countries to skip. So they plan to visit 9 different countries out of 13, so they're going to be skipping 4. However, the order in which they skip those countries doesn't matter. It's not specified that the order matters. Therefore, this is a combination. In number 3, it states the batting order for 7 players on a 12-person team. Well, right away we can see, since this is a batting order, order will matter. If we're looking for 7 players on a 12-player team, we could pick 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 out of that 12. That could be one batting order. Another batting order, using those same players, could be 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. They're up to bat in a completely different order, even though they're the same numbers. Therefore, in number 3, we have a permutation since order matters. In number 4, there are 45 applicants for 3 computer program positions. The computer program positions do not specify that they are different, and there's a total of 45. Therefore, choosing 3 out of those 45, regardless of the order, if we were to choose the first 3 in order 1, 2, 3, or the first 3 in order 3, 2, 1, it doesn't matter. Again, we could choose the 5th person, the 10th person, and the 20th person, and then we could go back and choose the 20th person, the 10th person, or the 5th person. The order in which we choose those doesn't matter. So this is a combination. For the rest of this worksheet, it says to state if each scenario involves a permutation or a combination. So like what we did in numbers 1 through 4, except now we're going to find the number of possibilities. So in number 5, it says Castle and Joe are planning a trip to 3 countries this year. There are 7 countries they would like to visit. One trip will be 1 week long, another 2 days long, and then another 2 weeks. So the order in which they choose those countries matters because which country they choose first, second, or third has different times associated with it. So the order in which they choose the countries determines how long they're going to be staying in that country. So order does indeed matter, therefore this is a permutation. Now let's calculate the number of possibilities. If there are 7 countries they would like to visit, but they're only planning a trip to 3, that's going to be 7P3, which is 7 factorial, n factorial, over n minus r factorial, 7 minus 3 factorial. So that's 7 factorial over 4 factorial, which is 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 factorial, all over 4 factorial. My 4 factorial will cancel out, so this will just be 7 times 6 times 5, which is 210 different permutations or different possibilities. In number 6, there are 110 people at a meeting. They each shake hands with everyone else. How many handshakes were there? Well, regardless of which person you shake first, you're going to eventually shake every single person. But the order in which you shake does not matter. Therefore, this is a combination. Combination because order doesn't matter. If there are 110 people at a meeting and they shake hands with everyone else, at any given time, we can say we're choosing two of those people to shake hands. So out of the 110, we're going to be choosing two to shake hands. So that's going to be 110 factorial, n factorial, over r factorial, which is 2 factorial, times n minus r factorial, 110 minus 2. So that's 110 factorial over 2 factorial times 110 minus 2 is 108. And that's 108 factorial. So simplifying, 110 times 109 times 108 factorial divided by 2 factorial times 108 factorial, which 2 factorial is simply 2. So that's 2 times 108 factorial. 108 and 108 factorial will cancel out. So we'll have 110 times 109, and then we're dividing that by 2. That will give us 5,995 for handshakes. And number 7, you are setting the combination on a 3-digit lock. You want to use the numbers 1, 2, 3, but you don't care what order they're in. Even though you don't care what order they're in, for a 3-digit lock, the order in which those numbers are placed matters. So this is a permutation. So this is going to be 3P3, because out of those three numbers, we're going to be combining each of those together to form the permutations. So that's 3 factorial over 3 minus 3 factorial, which 3 factorial is 3 times 2 times 1, and 3 minus 3 factorial is 0 factorial, which is 1. So 3 times 2 times 1 over 1 is 6. So there will be 6 different possibilities of arranging the numbers 1, 2, 3 for our 3-digit lock. And number 8, a group of 25 people are going to run a race. The top 8 finishers advance into the finals. So just the top 8 finishers advance, but the order of those 8 does not matter. Therefore, this is a combination. And out of the 25, we're choosing 8. So that's 25 factorial over 8 factorial times 25 minus 8 factorial. That's 25 factorial over 8 factorial times 25 minus 8 is 17 factorial. So calculating that math out on my calculator, using my factorial symbol, I'll have 25 factorial, and I'm going to be dividing that by 8 factorial times 17 factorial, making sure my 8 and 17 factorials are both within parentheses, so I'm dividing by that quantity. And that will give me 1,081,575. That's how many different possibilities there are for 8 people finishing in the top out of 25 total people. And number 9, a team of 17 softball players needs to choose 3 players to refill the water cooler. It doesn't matter which order those 3 players are in because they're completing the same task, and the order in which they do that doesn't matter. Therefore, this is a combination. So we're going to have 17, and we're choosing 3 out of those 17. That's 17 factorial over 3 factorial times n minus r, 17 minus 3 factorial. So that's 17 factorial all over 3 factorial times 14 factorial, which, doing this out by hand, is 17 times 16 times 15 times 14 factorial all over 3 factorial, which is 3 times 2 times 1, which is the number 6, times 14 factorial. Crossing out my 14 factorials, I'll do 17 times 16 times 15, which equals 4,080. And when I divide that by 6, I'll get 680 as the number of possibilities. And number 10, 5 out of 13 students will ride in a car instead of a van. The order that we choose those students does not matter. Therefore, this is a combination. And we're going to do 13, choose 5, which is 13 factorial over 5 factorial times 13 minus 5 factorial. So that's 13 factorial over 5 factorial times 8 factorial. Typing that into my calculator, 13 factorial divided by 5 factorial times 8 factorial within parentheses is 1,287. Also note that you can use NCR on your calculator by clicking the math button, going over to probability, and scrolling down to number 3, which is NCR, which automatically calculates the formula for you. You type your number for N, then press the NCR, and then finally your number for R and hit equals. That will give you 1,287. For number 11, the student body of 10 students wants to elect a president, vice president, secretary, and treasurer. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4 different positions. So the order in which they select those will matter. Therefore, this is a permutation. And we're going to be doing 10P4. So that's 10 factorial all over 10 minus 4 factorial. So that's 10 factorial over 6 factorial, which I know will simplify to 10 times 9 times 8 times 7. And then we will multiply by 6 factorial and divide that all by 6 factorial. However, I'm just skipping a step since I know they will cancel out. So 10 times 9 times 8 times 7 will equal 5,040. So this is a permutation with 5,040 possibilities. And number 12, we're selecting which 7 players will be in the batting order on an 11-person team. Now right away in number 12, I want to say that this is a permutation. Because if you remember back in number 3, when we selected the batting order, it was a permutation. However, as opposed to creating that batting order, we're just selecting 7 players that will be in it. We're not actually ordering those 7 players yet. So as opposed to actually putting those 7 players in an order, we're just choosing them out of the 11. Therefore, this is a combination. So I'll have 11, and I'm choosing 7 out of those 11 to put into the batting order, although I'm not yet ordering them. I'm just choosing which ones I'm going to eventually order. That's what this statement is saying. So I'm going to have 11 factorial all over 7 factorial times 11 minus 7 factorial. That's 11 factorial all over 7 factorial times 4 factorial, which is 11 times 10 times 9 times 8 times 7 factorial all over 7 factorial times 4 factorial is 4 times 3 times 2, which is 24. So 4 factorial equals 24. Now, my 7 factorial and 7 factorial will cancel out of the denominator and the numerator. So I'll have 11 times 10 times 9 times 8 all over 24. 11 times 10 times 9 times 8 is 7,920, and if I divide that by 24, I'll get 330. So there are 330 different possible ways to pick 7 players out of an 11-person team. And number 13, it states there are 15 applicants for 4 jobs: computer programmer, software tester, manager, and systems engineer. Because those 4 jobs are different, the order in which we choose the people or applicants does matter. Therefore, this is a permutation. And out of those 15 jobs, we're eventually picking 4 people. So that's 15 factorial all over 15 minus 4 factorial. So 15 factorial all over 15 minus 4, which is 11 factorial. That'll be 15 times 14 times 13 times 12 times 11 factorial all over 11 factorial. My 11 factorial will cancel out in the numerator and the denominator, so I'll have 15 times 14 times 13 times 12, which will give me 32,720. So 32,720 different ways that we can pick those four positions. And lastly in this video, number 14. A group of 45 people are going to run a race. The top three runners earn gold, silver, and bronze. So the order in which they finish that race matters because that will give them either gold, silver, or bronze. Because the order matters, this is a permutation. So we're going to have 45 people, and out of those 45, we're going to list the different possibilities that the top three runners could be. So this is 45 factorial all over 45 minus 3 factorial. That's 45 factorial all over 45 minus 3, which is 42 factorial. So 45 times 44 times 43 times 42 factorial, since then we will multiply by 41, 40, 39, and so on until 1, all over 42 factorial. 42 factorial and 42 factorial will cancel each other out to equal 1. So we'll just have 45 times 44 times 43, which is 85,140. That is the final solution on this worksheet. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. And if you haven't done so yet, go ahead and subscribe to my channel. And while you're at it, if you found this video useful, click that like button. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated. So thank you for doing that.